डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी नो कि इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल सोल्यूशन ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन वी हैव डिस्कस द टेलर सीरीज मेथड. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट यूलर्स मेथड. व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द यूलर्स मेथड? लेट अस लुक. लेट अस कंसीडर द इनिशियल वैल्यू प्रॉब्लम y डैश इज इक्वल टू f ऑफ एक्स वाई, वेयर एट y एट x नॉट इज इक्वल टू y नॉट. लेट अस कंसीडर दिस एज एन इक्वेशन नंबर वन. The Euler's method is based on, this is very important, you have to remember, the Euler's method is based on the property that in a small interval, a curve is nearly a straight line. This is a well-established property in mathematics, and this Euler's method is totally based upon this property. Once again, I am repeating, on the property that in a small interval, a curve is nearly a straight line. Now, if you consider x in between x naught and x1, that is very close to each other, then we approximate the curve by the tangent at x naught, y naught. But the equation of tangent at x naught, y naught, from your school mathematics, you know very easily, y minus y naught is equal to the slope dy over dx at x naught y naught into x minus x naught. And here it can be rewritten, this portion can be rewritten as f of x naught y naught x minus x1. As you know, this dy over dx or y dash may be written as f of xy. So this is f of x naught y naught x minus x naught. And from the above equation, you may also write that y is equal to y naught plus f of x naught y naught into x minus x1. So y corresponding to x1 may be written as y1 is equal to y naught plus hf of x naught y naught, or you can say y2 is equal to y1 plus hf of x1 y1, and so on. Further, you can write y3 or y4 if required similarly. Okay. Now, what is the general step? So, in general, you can write yn plus 1 is equal to yn plus hf of xn yn. Now, if you talk about what is the geometrical interpretation of this Euler's method, then it is very easy. You can look here. It is curve chosen as per the assumption of Euler's method. This is, this curve is nearly to a straight line. Okay, so if you consider the two points on this curve, that is P, the point P and the point Q, then you look and the point is here x naught, two point and x1. Then you look if the P is x naught, y naught and Q is x1, y1, then of course here you can make this line. That is a nearly straight on the curve, and their slope is already given. The slope is, if you consider, then this slope is like theta. So tan theta, you can calculate tan theta is what? That is this difference is del x, and this aq, the a is here and this q is here. Then this aq is del y. So del y over del x may be, that is equivalent to tan theta. If this is the curve, y is equal to fx. Then, just coming here, since the curve is nearly a straight line, then del y may be written approximated as del x into tan theta. And you know this, what is this tan theta? That is dy slope, dy over dx at x naught, y naught into del x. So, dy over dx, the same formula may be developed. Y1 is approximated as y naught plus dy over dx at x naught, y naught multiplied by x1 minus x naught. You have to remember here, what is x? X is lying between xn to xn plus 1. So, the solution is assumed to follow the line of tangent. The line of tangent to y, x at xn, yn. And this is, of course, the yn plus 1 is equal to yn plus hf of xn yn. So this is the geometrical interpretation of Euler's method. Now, one important part because you know if for the solution of numerical solution of differential equation, as we discussed the Taylor series method, and the second we are going to we are discussing the Euler's method, the error component here is very important to get the, how we can calculate the error term. So error term, let y xn be the exact value of y at x is equal to xn, and yn plus 1 be the computed value of y at x is equal to xn plus 1. Then the truncation error after one step may be expressed as this truncation error. If we denote with tn plus 1, then tn, what is the value of tn plus 1? That value will be y at xn plus 1 minus y n minus 1. Okay, this is the difference. Usually we know what is the error. Error is always defined, the basic definition of the error is the difference between the true value and approximate value. So in the same sense we define here also, so y xn plus 1 minus y n plus 1. So y xn plus 1, and here in the Euler's theorem we have seen it is y n plus 1, this y n plus 1 can be written into this yn plus h f of xn yn. Now on simplification you will get h square by 2 yn double dash xi. Here you mind it, xi is the term between xn and xn plus 1. Then here I will elaborate this complete knowledge in the for the numerical problem also, and for your knowledge point of view under 3-4 notes. So you look the first note. What Euler's method say? Euler's method is a first order method. It means the local error means error accumulated at every instance. That is called in numerical analysis local error. The local error, if we denote this as EL, is proportional to the square of h. What is h? H has been assumed as a step size. The step size is denoted by h. And global error. Global error means that is the error at a given steps in total. So that is proportional to the step size. So this is proportional to the step size. How it work? You look further in the next PPT. This truncation error, that is, I have already explained in the previous note, this means the global error, how it generated? It generated at every step. So, because of that, this is called truncation. Okay? And the global error means from all the steps in totality. So here we will use these two terms. So what Taylor series says? We have already seen in the previous lecture, in Taylor series, yn plus 1 may be written as yn plus h yn dash plus h square by factorial 2 yn double dash and so on up to hn by factorial n yn of the order nth order yn. Then and here of course we know a dy over dx can be symbolically written as y dash, and that is f of xy. Now you look by considering these equations, you can write yn plus 1 is nothing but yn plus h f xn yn and plus this term. Now you look very easily it is seen here. If this is Euler's method, and this is what? This is the error component, which we have calculated in the previous method also. But here we don't forget what we have chosen. H should be very, very smaller. Euler's method ki a limitation hai. H jitna chota loge, value will be more accurate. The h should be very, very less than 1, then of course h square by factorial 2 f dash xn yn become the larger. If it is larger like h square, we can assume the larger like h square, because of that this is called order of h square. It is it will be more clear here. Just you look here in the bottom, h decreases, then number of steps increases. How it? Let us consider, I have considered a line OL of the length 1. Let us consider as 1 unit. Okay? So if you consider H, the step size is 0.5 only, the N will be 2. But if you consider the point step size is 0.25, then N will become 4. if you consider h as 0.2, then n become 5. It means h decreases, then number of steps increases. And now it means the global error is nothing but the local error multiplied by 1 by h. So what is the, we have already calculated here, what is the local error? Local error is order of h square multiplied by 1 by h. It means the global error, the order in the global error is order of h only. So this is about Euler's method. Error analysis in Euler's method. Now, just to look one example, using Euler's method, find the approximate value of y corresponding to x is equal to 1, and it is also given that dy over dx is equal to x plus y, and y is equal to 1 when x is equal to 0. So how you can solve this Euler's method? By using Euler's method, we may take n is equal to 10 and h is equal to 0.1. If it is depend upon you, on your choice, then you always select the smaller value of h. That is for accuracy point of view. If you choose much smaller, then only the labor will be much, but the accuracy will be good in the Euler's method. So here I have chosen n is equal to 10 and h of course 0.1, which is sufficiently small. Then the all the calculation, it is advisable to you ki always in the Euler's method and Euler's next method, I will discuss Euler's modified method. Then in both the method you follow the practice to prepare the to compute all the values in a tabular form. As I have already written here, I have drawn this table. The calculation may be tabulated as, just to look the first value of course, x, y, and then already given dy over dx, what is given? That is given x plus y, x plus y is here. Then this is the new table. You have to remember, in new y, how you will go further step by step, just by calculating the new y. So how you will calculate the new y? With help of old y plus 0.1, already the steps you have chosen, multiplied by dy over dx, and dy over dx is here. Then just you look, x is already at, when x is equal to 0, it is given in the problem. It means 0.0, y is 1.0, the dy over dx is x plus y, that is of course 1, but new y, just to look, new y means old y, old y means 1, so 1 plus 0.1, that is step size, into dy over dx, that is 1. It means this 1 is here. Then on calculation you will get 1.10. Similarly, 0.1 next step, then this will become 1.10. How it become 1.10? Here, this value. So this value is 1.10 here, and then x plus y, 0.1 plus 1.10, that is 1.20. And then again here, 1.10, this value here, 1.10, old y, and then plus 0.1, and into 1.20, that is 1.22. Similarly, you can do for all the values, means 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, and you will get 0.9. Just to check it and fill all the blank, you do yourself all the in-between calculation just for your practice, and at 0.9, you will get 2.81, and the value dy over dx is 3.71, and here on calculation you will get 3.18. Then how to write the answer here? The last step, of course, what is required at 1.0, the length that is 1, it is already given at y is equal to 1. So 1.0, the value of course, the last value, that will be 3.18. So you may write that this is the required approximate value of y. So this is the required approximate value of y, and here you can end your calculation because you got the required value of y at the desired point. Now, if you look again the Euler's method, then you can very easily point out what is the advantages and disadvantages of Euler's method. Let us look. Advantages means Euler's method is simple and direct, okay? But if you call the disadvantage, then Euler's method is very slow for a smaller value of h, you may experience, okay? Second, in advantage, he may also be used for non-linear initial value problems. Sometime you might have the experience during the solution of ordinary differential equation, especially whenever you you try to solve the differential equation by linear differential equation or by exact method, then you might have the experience that there are several ODE which cannot solve by those traditional methods, but here you can solve those methods by considering the Euler's method. So this is one of the strength of the Euler's method. It may also be used for non-linear initial value problems. This method look nicely and this work effectively. You can get the solution at least. Good approximation is obtained with a very small value of h. So this is depend upon h. But if you just to look, if you want the good accuracy, then you have to do a very hard labor and very lengthy also. Sometimes, then if h is not small, then the method is inaccurate also. If by mistake or by any limitation, if you are not able to choose the smaller value of h, then the value will be, the method will give you the value which will be inaccurate. Okay. Now it is numerically unstable also. So with all these drawbacks, you can say these drawbacks suggest further modification, and the further modification you might be knowing, we will discuss in the next lecture, that is the Euler's modified method. There are many things in between Euler's method and Euler's modified. There are already the improved Euler's method also in between, and there are certain more things. But as I said, this is under the UG of all the Indian universities curricula. After Euler's method, we directly go and discuss the Euler's modified method. So at least for your practice point of view, at least you do some more problems from the book of your choice. At least 2-3 more problems you will do before trying to learn Euler's modified method. So here, I want to stop my lecture, and in the next lecture we will discuss Euler's modified method. Thank you very much. Stay safe and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much. Thank you.